It's 2025 and AI agents are here and they are transforming the way we get things done. In this video, I'll show you an AI agent that I've built that you can use to store real contacts for your AI agent, your personal AI agent, to use at any time. You'll have your agent update info about your contact without having to press more than a button. And lastly, you'll have your very own AI agent track family or friends' interest and birthdays to give you better suggestions on what to do for that person or what to gift them. And it'll act as your very own personal assistant. I'll show you a demo of this AI agent, and then I'll actually dive in to show you how it's working. As you guys can see, we have n8n pulled up to the right here. This is the workspace and the workflow of the AI agent that we're using for today. This is called n8n, and this is where you can use to build automations and your AI agents. And to the left, I hooked up the AI agent in our Telegram. I chose to do Telegram because it's easily accessible on your phone with an app, and it's just like texting a real person. We're going to be demoing the voice feature. Typically, you want to act like you're talking to your personal assistant. We'll be doing most of our talks in voice. And this is what you call a child agent. As you can see, I labeled it micro assistants right here. This is basically a tool that is being used by a bigger AI agent, which I'll show you in later videos, that passes information from the bigger agent into this contact agent to be used to perform the duties. Let's dive right into it. Hey, how are you doing today? I need the contact info of Frankie, spelled with two E's, and also Adonis. As you guys heard, I use Frankie, spelled with two E's, because I do have multiple Frankies in my own contact database, so I have to specify what Frankie to actually use. We go here into executions. You can see that it succeeded. We're just waiting for our AI agent to give us the information back. And as you can see right here to the right, I'm not going to show any of the contact info because, you know, obviously that's personal and that's sensitive. This is actually pulling from my own database, but it pulled up one of my friends, Adonis, and then myself, my name, which is Frankie Murphy right here. Don't worry, guys. We are in the execution tab, and this is what we'll be using to actually see how the data was passed and being used. I'll go over that after we have completed all of our test cases. So I'm going to actually mark this as scenario one. All right. And then we're going to mark that as good. And we're going to move on to the next demo. Do I know anyone in my contacts whose birthday is coming up soon? In this case, guys, I'm asking the AI agent, search my contacts and look for anybody that has birthdays coming up. Let's see what it says. As you can see here, guys, we do have a person that it did bring up February 23rd. It's actually February 24th here, or February 26th, actually. It can throw a little errors like that. And all that is, more than likely, is done within our system prompts, that we did not specify the time in our system prompt. Let's actually go ahead and do this live right now so we can specify the actual date. And so what I'm using right here, this is JSON coding right here that's basically telling the AI agent this is today's date and it's a point of reference. Let's save this and let's go ahead and try this again. Show me contacts with my friends in the next 2 to 3 months with birthdays coming up. Guys, I had to go ahead and change the system message up a little bit just so I can get back exactly what I want. Let's see what it says right here. Then we'll dive into the system message. Perfect. So as you can see, it knows this point of reference of our date right now. We have two Dons, which is wrong. I do have two Dons within my contacts. I do need to make change of that. And we do have some other people as well with birthdays coming up. It is February 26th right now, so it is pulling in the next 2 months. It's about to be March, and April obviously is after that. Let's go into our executions and mark this as succeeded so we can look at the data later on. I'm gonna do scenario two. Okay, we'll dive into the system message to see exactly how I structured that content and what I used for it to fully understand to pull the next birthdays in the coming months, and using the point of reference date to be able to know what date we're in to even pull in the next 2 months. Let's go ahead and test our last scenario so we can move in and understand how this AI agent is actually working. Update for my contact Frankie Murphy that he likes programming AI and automation agents. So we're using the update contact tool right here. And let's go ahead and go into executions. As you can see, it's running. Let's see what it puts out. And it says, hey, the contact information for Frankie Murphy has been successfully updated, that he likes programming AI and automation. And just to show you this is not fluff, we're going to go right into our contacts, our Google contacts, simply so you guys can see how it updated in real time. So we're going to go to Google contacts. All right. gonna go here. This is all gonna be blurred out so you don't see my contact information. We're gonna go to Frankie. Man, look at that handsome guy. And you can see that it says likes programming AI and automations, just like what it said here. We can also redo this so we know that is working in real time. Actually, let's perform another test right now to see if it keeps on adding notes. Hey, I actually need you to change Frankie Murphy's note to include that he likes apples and oranges. Let's see if it actually does it. So it's going to take its time. It's going to load. Boom, boom, boom. Dun, dun. And it says it successfully updated the note. Let's refresh this. As you can see, it attached the string along to the note that we already have. So perfect, guys. We successfully completed 3 test cases. And let's dive right into seeing how this AI agent is actually working. So if you guys remember, our first scenario was asking the AI agent, can you pull the contact info of a couple of friends of mine and then return it back to me so I know exactly their phone numbers and any other relevant information about them. Within n8n, the cool thing is for each test that you execute, whether you're in a test environment or in the production environment, you can take that data and pin it to all of the nodes that you use to see how it's being used in real time. We're going to break down each node one by one here. In the first node, when executed by another workflow, again, this is reference to a parent agent that is passing the information to the child agent. And this child agent is called contacts agent. And what this is doing is giving the agent an input parameter, meaning is passing information into the input parameter to be used for later context. And the query right now is get contact information for Adonis. And it knows that I asked for Adonis and Frankie's information. So it's actually performing that loop every time for each person it identified that we're trying to pull information for. So that query was get information for Adonis. We moved here into the actual node of the AI brain itself. Think of this as the AI brain that determines what to do. You'll see here in the query that this is the input parameter and it's coming from this previous node. As you can see, it'll even let you know that it's one node back so you know where it's pulling from exactly if you have multiple of the same nodes. In this case, this is a trigger, so typically we won't have any other triggers when it's executed by another workflow. I mean, you can, but it'll get a little bit more difficult if you build out AI agents that way. But the query is get information for Adonis. We are looking at it in the JSON point of view. You can look at it in different ways, schemas, wherever you want to say. I personally like to look at it in the JSON view. It's just easier for me to notice. The schema is the same type of view, just a better UI. Now, this is the input side of the brain of the contact agent. We also have the middle, which I want to say is kind of like the prefrontal cortex. It's the part of the brain that you're actually programming. And then on the right here, you can see what it's putting outside of the brain, the actual success of actually putting in the input parameters and programming it. So we'll focus on what is actually happening here inside of the brain. Here, the agent, we have the tools option. So what this is doing essentially is letting us know, hey, choose a tool, what we need to use for this query. The source for prompt, basically in AI, it's just like using ChatGPT. We're defining the query below. It's like you typing into ChatGPT what you're trying to accomplish. What we're trying to accomplish, you can see here in real time, that it says get contact information for Adonis. The system message here, this is how we're programming the AI agent. So if you have any familiarity programming GPTs, I'll just assume you're not. Essentially, you're going into the system message and letting the AI agent know this is what you do for each tool and when to call upon each tool. What are tools? Well, tools are what we defined out here. So you can see here, if we scroll a little bit more, zoom in, these are each of our tools. So we have the search contacts, update contact, create contact, and get all contacts from Google. This part right here, the chat model is essentially the brain that we're using for the contact agent to call upon these tools. And again, this is like the nervous system and the chat model is like the brain. We can call on any LLM. This can be any type of LLM, whether it's OpenAI, Claude, Gemini, we can call from that. Now guys, let's dive into the system message. So in this case, we are trying to get contact information for Adonis. So within my tools, we have something called the search tool. And this tool is used to find specific contact information automation in Google Contact. This is what I am saying to basically tell the AI, use this tool, but to only use this tool first before retrieving all contacts for information. Before retrieving all contacts if we can't find the tool. And I'm using the search contacts tool to find the first name or full name or the last name, whatever I ask for, try to find it first using this search contacts tool. If not, use the get all contacts from Google function if I can't find this specific person, and then try to sort and parse through the data there and see if you can find that contact information there. So once that actually happens, it goes down into this tool called search contacts. We are using the get many operation here. And the reason why we're doing that is because we don't know the specific contact ID of the person called Adonis. And so what we're doing is looking in all of the contacts with and only returning back one output if it can find that contact. And we want it to return the addresses, the emails, names, phone numbers, blah, blah, blah. And we are also using a query for this. And the reason why we're using a query is because we want to keep this all within AI's parameters. We want to use AI for this. We don't want to have to directly program how to find this person or any person we're searching for. Within n8n, they actually have a cool JSON piece of code here that's called from AI. And what this does essentially is from AI looks up a name. We're actually telling it that look for a name. This will populate the parameter of name. And what this parameter does essentially is it's telling the AI look for the name. The name here is Adonis. So it is assuming based off the input that it got from the AI brain itself, meaning get the contact information for Adonis. It's assuming that Adonis is the name and is automatically placing it into here. And is also letting it know that it is a string. The cool thing about this, guys, is AI is doing this all in the background. You're telling the AI to assume this. You're having good faith in the AI that it will return the right information. Sometimes if it doesn't return the right information, you just have to reprogram your system message so it can bring back and populate the correct information. And you can see here on the output that it was able to find the correct information. All of the related info that is being returned that we addressed here in the fields. And it's going to send that information back to the contact agent. And it's going to populate the right message based off what I asked for it in the beginning, and then send it off via the response. And the response will send a JSON output, which is essentially just the information that it got from the AI brain itself, and send that back up the chain to be delivered back to the end user. We are in scenario two. And if you guys remember, the scenario two had to deal with asking the AI agent, can you bring up any of my friends or contacts information within the next 2 months and return it back to me. So if we go here into when executed by another workflow, the previous AI agent determined that, hey, he is asking list of contacts with birthdays in February and March. So it knows that we are looking for the contact agent, and it needs to plug that query into the contact agent's brain. When we look at the contact agent's brain, it's going to show the query that it received from the previous node. We're defining the user prompt, and the user prompt again is list contacts with birthdays in February and March. We're going to go into the system message, and it used actually the get all contacts from Google. And the reason why I use the get all contacts from Google is because I didn't define a specific name to search for or a specific birthday to search for it. Instead, I'm asking on a granular level, what contacts do I have that have birthdays in the next 2 months? So AI is intelligent enough to know that we need to call on the tool of get all contacts, use this tool or retrieves all list of contacts stored in Google just so we can save time and effort without actually diving in, searching contacts one by one. So if we go into our tool, get all contacts for Google, what is the same exact look of the search contacts node because we are using the same operation. And what it's doing is parsing through this information and deciding what information, what birthdays are in the next 2 months. And the reason we're not using a query here is because we're not looking for a specific person again, and we're returning all of the information, and we're letting the AI brain decide what birthdays are in the next 2 months. Again, that's all we use. So it sends that information back up to the contact agent, and in response, it'll let us know here's the list of contacts in February and March. It also knows that the birthdays that we're searching for is within the next 2 months. I forgot to mention how the AI agent knows that the birthdays we're looking for is within March and April is because I defined it here that whatever today's date is, it's a dynamic formula that we're using that the AI agent can always call upon to know where it's at a point of reference. Right, y'all, we're in the last scenario here. And if you remember, this is when we asked the AI agent to add the note to a contact being Frankie Murphy within my Google contacts that he likes AI automation and apples and bananas or pears or whatever around there. We're going to dive into the when executed workflow, and you'll see here that it says update the note for Frankie Murphy to include that he likes apples and oranges. And it sends that input parameter again within the AI brain and using that as the user message. And from there, we're calling upon the tool within the system message saying, hey, this is how you use the update contacts tool. Use this tool to update existing contacts in Google Contacts. And before updating a contact, ensure you know you have the correct contact ID. What this does is looking for Frankie Murphy first. So it's calling on the tool search contacts. So it has to first bring up the ID of Frankie Murphy in order to know what contact to make changes to. So it's calling upon that ID, and it's looking for the ID. Then it sends back up that information into the contact agent. And so once the contact agent knows, okay, we have the right contact, then it's appropriate that we'll use the update contact tool. And as you can see here in the update contact tool, and the input has all of the relevant information of Frankie Murphy. Now that we were able to search for the correct contact, we're going to append those details into that note. To break down the middle part here of the actual tool, we're using the credentials, which is set up with my account to know what contacts we're searching for and what contact book that we're using. The resource, we're just using contacts because this is the contact node. We're not making a custom API call. We want to make this as simple as possible. We're using the update operation. We're not searching, we're not deleting, we're not creating. And if we go into here, the contact ID, again, we want to make this as AI as possible. And n8n has the syntax that we can use JSON to basically tell AI to take an estimate of the contact ID based off the input parameter. So as you can see here, the contact ID was this, and we are telling AI take what the contact ID is, the name of this parameter. It will estimate something around this name, this contact ID, and then place that in there. And it correctly did that well. Then next, we're telling the AI what fields to update. Based off my query, it will know what specifically to update. It knows that my name is Frankie. It knows that my name already is given name. That's not what I'm asking. So it's pulling from whatever it received from the search contacts, and it is placing it into the update, whatever change from what I'm giving it within the query. If we go down here, I didn't make any changes to the email. I made changes to the notes. It knows that I am using likes apples and oranges. So it is pulling the notes as well and adding that likes apples and oranges to that. And then it's spitting back out that information with the correct updated contact and sending that back up to the brain of the contact agent and back out through the response and letting it know that I've successfully updated the notes for Frankie Murphy. And that is the JSON output that it sends back up. That is it, guys. That is how the contact agent is working. Also, if there is any time an error in your contact agent or any agent in general, it's important that you have this try again message here that it also sends back up to the user, letting it know that an error occurred. If you guys want this AI agent, you can receive it completely free by joining my community in the link below. I also have a newsletter, a free newsletter that you guys can sign up for to receive the latest trends in AI agents and AI and also emerging technologies in the field. We must stick together. The newsletter is for like-minded people that want to upskill and break into AI and also build AI agents for their personal life and their actual business, and it's completely free. I appreciate you all for liking. Don't forget to like and subscribe and share with someone that is interested in AI, AI agents, or also in automations. I'll see you guys in the next video, and don't forget to embrace your potential.